Insanity, I am the beast that ace, cancel me. Granted, he is handsome, handsome with the bread, but underneath my underfeet, I cannot see the soul. Up in the grease like the holes in the ozone, up in the heat like holes in the snow globe. You rich, your beast get froze, check the logo. Hey, H, kill haters, call the docs, patience. When I'm stuck in praise surveillance, watch my patience. Take your plate right off the table, tell them, wait here, waiters waiting in my water. Fishy rappers hear the cadence, is it tip? When I drop down, you know it's time for praise.
Think I need a moment, man, I'm zoned out.
Whoever sees this and subscribes right now will get a free piece of paper. Lines not included. What's going on, YouTube? It's Knox Hill, and we're back with the reaction series. So today, man. Yes, I know, we have a different look, but I just could not wait to jump into NF's brand new album? No, it's a mixtape, it's an album, whatever it is. It's time to dive into the world of Clouds. I know what we have to do, people. So the song that I'm most excited about and that I want to do first to start this journey is none other than NF with an artist who I love and have looked up to for a long, long time. I'm talking about Tech 9. But before we go any further, guys, I'm going to give a quick shout out to the song in the intro. If you like that, yes, I am a rapper myself. There's a good chance you like my breakdowns. The way that I think about music, you'll probably like my music as well. I have a new album, Chaos Theory, 20 tracks, Blood, Sweat, and Tears, Heart, and Soul, guys. If you want to support me and support the channel directly, I'll put that link below. Also, this is your reminder that tomorrow, 1 p.m. EST, we will be live streaming. Yeah, I'm thinking about doing the full mixtape on the live. I mean, we'll see. But yeah, it's always a great energy, so be sure to come through and support that. But anyways, we know what we're here for. NF Tech 9. Step up to the plate. Let's see what you got. Whoa, I just paused at the worst moment. I had no idea he was about to come in there, but I was trying to get my mind wrapped around that string sound because it sounded like strings being off key, you know, like violin just being totally off in their notes as they're trying to be tuned. But then the more that I listen, I wonder if that is strings that have been reversed in the sound. So it's got sort of that weird kind of choppiness to the tone, but also like you just frequence that and put like a crazy reverb on it. And I think that's how that was achieved, man. That is just, that's eerie and epic. It's so cool. I love what they do with orchestral sounds on NF production, man. Wow. Whoever thought something so ugly could be so awesome?
Focus on it every single day. I want to figure out a way to get ahead of what I think I know is coming. Top of you, you got a problem if you...
Wow. Focus on it every single day. When I get ahead of every single thing I think that was coming. And that wasn't bad for a first rendition, but man, I love that fast flow. I mean, he knows in the back of his mind doing this track right now, he's got Tech 9, renowned to be a fast spitter. But NF, when he wants to spit fast, can spit fast too, man. So focus on the things that I know are coming. Well, what's coming? Fear? Angst? So many possibilities.
Focus on it every single day. I want to figure out a way to get ahead of what I think I know is coming. Top of you, you got a problem if you're always trying to make it seem as if you've never been afraid, then why you running? I can never look at what it...
Got a problem if you think you were never afraid, then why you running? Why are you acting like you have no fear, and yet you're running? Is that the fans talking to him in critique of him? Or is that him talking to himself and dealing with his own insecurities? Because it's always funny listening to NF's music, because as rappers, there's so much confidence and ego and kind of bravado that we carry with our delivery and performance. And NF, yeah, he has his moments when he swags out. I mean, come on, we have to be that as MCs. But at the same time, he's so vulnerable with his songs. And I just love that contrast between what a rapper is understood as and how he just opens himself up on the microphone.
You know what's coming. Top of you, you got a problem if you're always trying to make it seem as if you've never been afraid, then why you running? I can never look at what I do, the way that other people can and walk away. I can't be separated from it. Sticking out my neck is how I made it where I'm at. You want to cut it up, I can't, and they can never take it from me.
Sticking out my neck is how I made it. I mean, he's created his own lane, his own style. We've talked about this, and they can never take that from him, no matter if they cut it up. I like how he puts that. And think about this, all right? You get this beat. You start working with it, and it's just strings in the background. There's no percussion driving this. There's nothing else. To take strings that are so much more emotional and melodic than just to rap crazy fast, But he's so good at keeping his metric schemes and keeping just his flows in these tight pockets, man. I mean, to come fast on that just takes a different sort of level of creativity and thought.
Separated from it, sticking on my neck is how I made it where I'm at. You want to cut it up, I can, and they can never take it from me. Outlandish, take chances, got to get it while I can with my damage. My sanity could leave it if it vanished. Don't matter to me, I'd still manage.
Yeah, guess you could say I'm at an advantage. Come on now. Those flows, man, are just silky, silky smooth.
And they can never take it from me. Outlandish, take chances, gotta get it while I can with my damage. My sanity could leave it if it...
Outlandish, tight damage, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. I love how he comes up, down, and just pushes pace in between.
Vanished, don't matter to me, I'd still manage. Yeah, guess you could say I'm at an advantage. My vantage point can be quite lavish. Got so many cadences, no way to pick one. Which bag is my hand in? Depends on...
So many cadences, which way to pick? So true, though. So true. We've talked about his vocal control and just his microphone presence, man. And I've never heard someone rap so low and have so much power and impact on the mic when he drops down. And then he comes out and he can yell. He can go fast. He can go slow. He can attack you in so many ways.
Oh, no, I'm in a mood again. Lord knows I'm a hooligan.
What is that flow? Hold up.
My vantage point can be quite lavish. Got so many cadences. No way to pick one. Which bag is my hand in? Depends what mood I'm in. Oh, no, I'm in a mood again. Lord knows I'm a hooligan. Losing it.
Oh, no. Lord knows I'm in a mood again. So, like, step back for a moment, and then come close. Step back, come close. Love that riding a wave sort of contrast on the delivery.
Depends what mood I'm in. Oh, no, I'm in a mood again. Lord knows I'm a hooligan. Losing it. Who can get gruesome with you if it comes down to it? You can bet. I shoot direct, defuse the threat. And
oh, my God, this is crazy.
Who can get gruesome with you if it comes down to it? You can bet. I shoot direct, defuse the threat. And then wonder why the music has a huge effect. Could it be because I've been the go-to when it comes to depth? Because I'm the one that they be calling when the people...
They wonder why the music has such a huge effect. Could it be because I'm the one who's the go-to when it comes to death? Yeah, it's great making those radio hits and those singles everybody wants to dance to and ride out to. But we all have down moments in life, you know? We all get sad at times. We all question ourselves. Who do we turn to then when we want deeper meaning, when we're looking for more? Turn to artists like NF. So well put.
And I wonder why the music has a huge effect. Could it be because I've been the go-to when it comes to depth? Cause I'm the one that they be calling when the people get fed up. I want the music with the visuals. I got a vendetta for any part of me that want to make it hard to get.
I'm the one they call when people get fed up. Again, listen to that. He's like attacking. He's more aggressive with his delivery over top of this percussion. Then when it drops down, he drops down his cadence. I mean, man, so undervalued with NF. And then that fast delivery still, he's just chopping it up. And his syllables is so well enunciated. You can just catch every single word that he's saying right now, you know? He's the one they call when they want the visuals. Because is he making movies or music videos? We still don't know.
Yeah, because I'm the one that they be calling when the people get fed up. I want the music with the visuals. I got a vendetta for any part of me that want to make it hard to get set up. But take away the happiness, it can be kind of pathetic. But when I look at everything, it's trying to give me a headache. You got to be honest, I've really been the cause of it. Get it? Because I can see inside of me. You never see. You can tell when I'm at the breaking point. I finally had to sit with the devil. I went into hell and ass.
Whoa, hold up. So talking about getting a headache from all this, but then realizing that he's the cause of it. And then where's it going
hard
now?
To get set up, but take away the happiness, it can be kind of pathetic. But when I look at everything, it's trying to give me a headache. You gotta be honest, I've really been the cause of it. Get it? Because I can see inside of me. You never see. You can tell when I'm at the breaking point. I finally had to sit with the devil. I went into hell and I asked him what the problem is yelling. He tried to get me to live with him. Even call me a sinner and tell me everything.
What? Wow. I love the religious imagery now. Talking about the devil trying to get him to live with them. Calling him a sinner. This is really well put.
And they had to sit with the devil. I went into hell and I asked him what the problem is yelling. He tried to get me to live with him. Even call me a sinner and told me everything about me doesn't feel like a winner. So I continue when he's telling me I might as well give up. I took a moment, thought about it, feeling caught in the middle. But got offended when he told me I would live in the kennel when I could.
Caught in the middle, like, you know, living on planet Earth between heaven and hell. Feeling like he's caught in the middle, proverbially. Man, I love the way that he's painting this picture right now. And obviously all those self-doubts. You know the saying, like having a devil on his shoulder? Well, he's kind of taking that and making it the actual devil. You know, all these doubts and internal conflicts going on in his head. So while he is talking about the literal devil, he's also personifying those inner demons through that language. That's really well put and poetic, man.
When he's telling me I might as well give up, I took a moment, thought about it, feeling caught in the middle, but got offended when he told me I would live in the kennel when I could never leave it. Even if I made it to heaven, he found a way to give me back and send a demon to get me.
I'd be living in a kennel. Like in hell, but also in this internal hell. See, I take this as duality here, right? There's more than what he's just talking about on the surface. He's talking about his inner demons. He's talking about being trapped in a kennel in his own mind too. And then even if he makes it to heaven, even if he has his freedom, these thoughts and these devils will still pull him back down, and these demons. Wow.
But living in Canaan when I can never leave it, even if I made it to heaven, he found a way to give me back and send a demon to get me. I'm like, whoa, hold up. So skin and bones, me my ego. Ooh. How's he look? He don't eat much. Let him starve. I don't feed him. I just feed him.
Oh, I let him starve. I let my ego starve. I don't feed my ego. I never let myself get so full of myself from all this success that I have. I love that, man. He's still driven to this day, still pumping out more and more music for us.
My ego, how's he look? He don't eat much.
So he does take sort of that typical, you know, trap flow, throws that in for a second, but not long. Not long does he use that flow. Then he kicks back out with a faster pace.
Hold up, I don't think so. Skin and bones, me my ego. How's he look? He don't eat much. Let him starve. I don't feed him. I just beat him. I just leave him in his room, in a fetal. Let him cry. Let him yell. Let him scream. I don't need him.
Left off and I'm ticked off. My pitfalls I let.
Nice. Heavier percussive hit there. Let him cry. Let him scream. Let him yell. I don't feed him. Damn.
Let him yell. Let him scream. I don't need him.
Left off and I'm ticked off. My pitfalls I
Sorry, I don't need him. I mixed up the I don't need him with the I don't feed him, but he also said I don't feed him too. That's cool, man. I don't need my ego. I don't need any of this. Man, I mean, who else just dives into their own mind and their own psychology in such a way and just comes out with such ideas and symbolism to use?
Hey, let him yell, let him scream. I don't need him.
Left off and I'm ticked off. My pitfalls I latch onto like a pit dog. I sitcom with a sick thought of a sitcom of the life I live. Life I live's more like
sitcom with a sitcom of the da 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 da. Nice again. And you hear the pauses? Again, it's not always about what you say. It's what you don't say in those moments when you choose to pause and let things sink in. And what that's doing is chopping up his flow, but also letting some of these lines hit a little bit heavier because he's really dropped down the cadence again. Like, he'll push and he'll drop back down the cadence. And he'll push and drop back down.
Sci-fi flick, I sitcom with a sick thought of a sitcom of the life I live. Life I live's more like a sci-fi flick. I hide in, wanna watch, dive right in, my silence.
My life's more like a sci-fi flick. I think about it being like a sitcom, which is all nice and rosy, but really it's like sort of a sci-fi futuristic horror type of stuff. You want to dive in and see the gore that I'm dealing with.
I'm with a life I live. Life I live's more like a sci-fi flick. I hide in, wanna watch, dive right in. My silence doesn't mean I'm dying, just means I'm careful with the time I spend. So look what I do.
My silence doesn't mean I'm dying, just means I'm careful with the time I spent. And you know, true wisdom is not always talking a lot, but knowing when to be quiet. And knowing when to just let things sink in and only saying things that you truly mean.
My silence doesn't mean I'm dying, just means I'm careful with the time I spent. So look what I done. Hey, helping them people I love. My life is not what it was. No, I do whatever I must. Kind of one hand who I trust. Kind of one hand who I trust. Yeah, kind of one hand who I trust. Kind of one hand who I trust.
Ah, this must be the hook. Yeah, that's a dope concept. Count on one hand who I trust. That's how many true friends and true people that I have. I've got a very small circle, but a quality circle at the same time. I take that as, or it could be, I just have so few people that I do trust in this world. The more that I grow, the more fame that I get.
Kind of one hand who I trust. Yeah, kind of one hand who I trust. Kind of one hand who I trust.
Nina, next king up. Everyone knowing that I'm a death bringer. That lingua vexing, yeah, leaving a regular rapper resting.
Oh no, don't do that, Tech. Don't do that. Please, please, please. Come on, Tech. Tech man just gets in the car and he can go from 0 to 60 back to 30 to 100 like nothing with his flows.
One hand who I trust. Kind of one hand who I trust.
Nina, next king up. Everyone knowing that I'm a death bringer.
Everyone knowing that I'm a death bringer. Do 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 do. Instead of just having super chopper flow, I love how he has just a little bit of slow measured out and then throws the chopper in between it. And Tech Nina, Tech Nine, get it, the Nina. We got those.
Kind of one hand who I trust.
Nina, next king up. Everyone knowing that I'm a death bringer. That lingua vexing ya, leaving a regular rapper resting, bruh.
That lingua vexing ya. And he's got a depth of vocabulary too. Like lingua, right? Leading to the tongue. Man, that's nice.
Everyone knowing that
vexing ya, annoying ya, getting to you, cursing ya.
A death bringer. That lingua vexing ya, leaving a regular rapper resting, bruh. This is what I give it, such an incredible wicked rush. A vivid gush, a poetical livid stuff to rid it.
Livid stuff, did it, do? Live it, stuff, give it, crush, like triple syllabin scheme. But I love how he's just punching it, right? Like a staccato flow, pausing in between. Again, like NF did a little bit that we pointed out at that point in time. Listen to where he's sort of pausing just to break up the flow in between the fast paces. Really cool.
This is what I give it, such an incredible wicked rush, a vivid gush, a poetical livid stuff to rid its gruffs.
Vivid gush, like right there in between vivid gush, instead of just going naturally to vivid gush, there's like vivid, just a little bit of space before he goes with like the gush in those words. So he's doing those first two syllables like this and then just slightly pausing in between the delivery of that. I hope you guys realize how hard that is to do and to control when you're recording it.
This is what I give it, such an incredible wicked rush, a vivid gush, a poetical livid stuff to rid its
nice.
Rough, said I better go rip it rough and I lit it up, the prestige, I got that from people loving the text speed.
Ooh.
Lyrically elect me, gently, the beat that got you bobbing until your neck bleed.
Ooh.
Better telling me less.
Got your head bobbing till your neck bleed. Man, that is a hard line. And shout out to Jet Li.
Woo!
Bringing out the martial arts on this track, baby.
Lyrically elect me, Jet Li, the
wow, and then he even did an ad lib like the woo. Oh, okay, that's good.
I lit it up, the prestige. I got that from people loving the text speed.
Woo!
Lyrically elect me, Jet Li, the beat that got you bobbing until your neck bleed.
Woo!
That is telling me less feed on the bit of the bogus to hit up a focus. Deliver the doses and give a crit of the dopest. Bit into flow, sick another critic corrosive. A swig of the rogue is to give you liver cirrhosis. Boogie monster.
The corrosive, a little swig of the what was it?
Bit of the dopest, bit into flow, sick another critic corrosive. A swig of the roguish to give you liver cirrhosis.
Swig of the roguish. Like he's a rogue. Being roguish will give your liver cirrhosis. Like alcoholics get the blisters on their liver, they go through cirrhosis. So he's going to give us cirrhosis with his bars that he's bringing. Damn.
Doesn't give a crit of the dopest, bit into flow, sick another critic corrosive. A swig of the roguish to give you liver cirrhosis. Boogie monster, prep it with a neph and a hoodie wants us to.
And the question again, and I only thought about that because I keep saying damn, and normally I don't try to do any sort of cursing on NF tracks because I try to just match what he's doing, really. But Hobson got on the track and didn't curse. My question was, is Tech N9ne going to follow sort of Hobson's lead and sort of NF's lead on all of his tracks where he doesn't curse? And so far, no cursing. So I got a feeling he's going to carry that out too.
Another critic corrosive, a swig of the rogue is to give you liver cirrhosis. Boogie monster repping with an F and a hoodie wants to step into the session and fully conquer the weapon to lessen up.
Boogie monster repping with an F. The hoodie monster? Yo, did he record this with NF? Because I could see Tech just like kicking it with NF, then going in and freestyling this verse, man. That's dope.
Cirrhosis. Boogie monster repping with an F and a hoodie want to step into the session and fully conquer the weapon to lessen up professional bully bonkers. Left in the wreck, never checking the cutie stomp us.
Shake his crown.
Thought he was gonna make us run away in a battle with his
shake his frown. Shake his crown.
Like I'm the mecha Godzilla, I'm such a killer when I break it down.
Wait.
Shake his frown. Shake his crown. Like I'm the mecha Godzilla, I'm such a killer when I break.
Come on, Mecha Godzilla. Nice, man. I like those bars. Mecha Godzilla going up against Godzilla. So he's like the villain, but he's still a monster on the track. And one of the things that's always signature of Tech style and reminds me of sort of old school Bone Thugs, like do. And then some of the dubs, like the doubles, when he basically gets in the booth and just records the lines back. And he'll pick some of these lines and he'll put a couple layers on the dubs, basically. So he'll come with just his main track, right? And there's no other tracks underneath of it, like, to accentuate it. And he'll run with the main. And then just on certain moments, he'll just highlight with multi-layered just dubs behind it and ad-libs. That's so cool. It just, like, punches. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Punch. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Punch. So dope from a mixing point.
Gonna make us run away in a battle with a second frown.
Right there.
Like I'm the mecha Godzilla, I'm such a killer when I break it down.
Dope.
These flows are the cheat code for the weak Joes that need those elite bros with the heat so they
I mean,
can
what? What is this flow? What is this flow, Tech? Stop it. He's killing it.
These flows are the cheat code for the weak Joes that need those elite bros with the heat so they can eat on a D-low off a beast. Your ego got a veto. Please close your beak, foes. The least scrolls take it from me. Thieves chose to try to decode. Reload the beat so I can reach each soul. No cease, no finito. Release.
Go!
Reload the beat. Man. E-lo, do. I mean, the E internal schemes and then the O hard O schemes as well, man. Just mixing between the two is so cool.
The heat so they can eat on a D-lo off a beast. Your ego got a veto. Please close your beak, foes. The least scrolls take it from me. Thieves chose to try to decode. Reload the beat so I can reach each soul. No cease, no.
Reload the beat so I can reach each soul. I mean, he's still saying some powerful lyrics too at the same time at this crazy condensed internal
beat
scheme.
Foes, the least scrolls take it from me. Thieves chose to try to decode. Reload the beat so I can reach each soul. No cease, no finito. Release.
Go!
I am the chosen and everyone is beholding. My energy is golden because the minion is being broken from enemies in the open approaching. I'm never joking. The remedy being spoken. I'm hoping that you're soaking it up. I'm in the motion. I'm dope.
I am soaking it up, man. Wow. This is crazy.
Reach each soul. No cease, no finito. Release.
Go!
I am the chosen and everyone is beholding. My energy is golden because the minion is.
I am the chosen. My energy is golden.
Being broken from enemies in the open approaching. I'm never joking. The remedy being spoken. I'm hoping that you're soaking it up. I'm in the
remedy being spoken. I'm hoping that you're soaking it up. He's giving us that lyrical remedy, man.
Because the meaning is being broken from enemies in the open approach, and I'm never joking. The remedy being spoken, I'm hoping that you're soaking it up. I'm in the motion, I'm doping, I'm never choking. My devotion to floating like an ocean, the Holy Ghost, and I'm scoping the evil poking.
Floating like an ocean. I mean, he's still got wordplay condensed in that scheme too.
That you're soaking it up. I'm in the motion, I'm doping, I'm never choking. My devotion to floating like an ocean, the Holy Ghost, and I'm scoping the evil poking, provoking the wicked notion, I'm croaking. I'm really
to evil folk, and I'm scoping the wicked votes, and my God, the way that you have to write that to have. It's like every third syllable rhymes, sometimes every second syllable. That's crazy.
I'm never choking, my devotion to floating like a notion, the Holy Ghost, and I'm scoping the evil folk, I'm provoking the wicked notion, I'm croaking, I'm really floating and quoting, then I'm closing it up.
Wow.
Behind my back, end up with niners that see me and say, kind of like you could not find a night.
I mean, this is why he's a master on the mic, man. He's starting to lose me now.
Devotion to floating like a notion, the Holy Ghost, and I'm scoping the evil folk, I'm provoking the wicked notion, I'm croaking, I'm really floating and quoting, then I'm closing it up. Talking behind my back, end up with niners that see me and say, kind of like you could not find a night, hit you with a rhyme attack, really is great. I'ma beat you cause
well, hit you with a rhyme attack and spray. And I love there when he's doing the yells, because he's got those punchy yells, right? Sort of like NF's kind of style, you know, when he takes his yells and the ad-libs and just uses that to accentuate some of his lines.
Hey, kind of like you could not find a knock, hit you with a rhyme attack, really is spray. I'ma beat you cause I'm greedy and slay. If you creepy and cray, I'ma eat you like PB&J, kiwi and grapes.
If you creepy and cray, I'ma eat you like PB&J, kiwi and grapes. What a great scheme, and I love those lines.
I'ma beat you cause I'm greedy and slay. If you creepy and cray, I'ma eat you like PB&J, kiwi and grapes. I'ma demolish them when the TB and play. I started recording in my number three Jordans. Dungaree sporting, the tongue of me is...
Started recording in my number three Jordans. Wow. Air Jordan 3s, man. One of the, like, rarest and most sought after Air Jordan kicks on the market, man. He's swagging now.
Play. I started recording. And my number three Jordans, dungaree sporting. The tongue of me is gonna be scorching. The punishing hunter eat like a hungry orphan.
Punishing hunger eat like a hungry orphan. Wow, to bend that scheme. So good, man. There's just so much. Everything rhymes with itself. I mean, if you break this down and color-coded it, man, everything would be matching up. It's insane.
Three Jordans, dungaree sporting. The tongue of me is gonna be scorching. The punishing hunter eat like a hungry orphan. T9 and NF are elephants. In the room without a closet for skeletons. Quit and belly.
T9 and NF are elephants. You know the saying, like the elephant in the room? Well, they are the elephants in the room, literally. Without a closet full of skeletons, because, man, I really like those lines too. And he's shouting out NF there because, you know, NF doesn't have any skeletons in his closet. He literally just opens up his closet doors and shows it for the world to see through his music. And Tech N9ne too, man. He goes there deep into the psychoanalysis of himself.
Like a hungry orphan. T9 and NF are elephants. In the room without a closet for skeletons. Quit embellishing. A demon from hell is a yelling. When done, you're out of your element.
Look what I done.
That is my favorite line of the whole song. He just put out a big Lebowski line. Donnie, you're out of your element.
Quit embellishing. A demon from hell is a yelling. When done, you're out of your element.
Look what I done.
So good, and you listen, there's a lot happening. It's a simple hook, but he's just got like these yelling ad-libs. There's like these choir chants, ha, ha, just hitting out of nowhere. Just fills the space so well right now. Man, this is a jam. Yo, I want more. I want more, man. That wasn't enough. That was a crazy ride. Wow. I mean, I did have so many questions of how Tech, who really started with that demonic and sort of devil-worshipping imagery, right? I mean, it was very shock and awe when he first came out to deal with NF, who started as a very Christian rapper. You know, two very different styles, but also there's a similarity. Sort of this inner darkness within and dealing with your demons. And Tech will take those demons and sort of own them and personify them through his character and his music, whereas NF is constantly at a conflict with his demons. So, you know, different perspectives on sort of a similar area of just dark, twisted psychoanalysis. But wow, that was a ride, man. The fast flows, the cadence changes, that beat, haunting, orchestral. Wow, NF Tech 9? You were Noxo certified. So if you guys liked today's video, if you did, be sure to smash that like button. Comment down below any other NF songs you want to see me do, Tech 9 songs, or if there's other artists you want to see me check out. I try to read all of your comments, guys. I respond as much as I can, so please keep commenting and keep posting. Also, if you're here at the end of this video, do me a favor, subscribe, notifications on, so we can keep growing, keep building the buzz, and keep doing this. As always, it's your reminder to stay safe, to stay positive, guys. Don't forget tomorrow, live stream, 1 p.m. EST. I'm thinking about doing the full NF Clouds mixtape on that live. But anyway, stay tuned for that. I'll catch you guys soon. It's Knox Hill, and I'm out.